I mean, it would be likely that a release for Travis Denning is happening during a pandemic. Man, I'm sorry. This is when your debut is coming out. I'm happy to hear that it's happening, though.
Yeah, I know. Hey, at least the music's still coming. And I'm fired up, man. I'm fired up to give people this kind of first chapter of new music. And honestly, if they're like me, they're going stir crazy and they're bored. So hopefully new music will lift some spirits.
That's exactly right. I like the way that you're thinking about this. So tell me about this debut coming out. Beer's Better Cold, that's the name.
We got six songs. Of course, it's a six-pack with Beer's Better Cold. Why not?
Well played. Okay, give me the insight into what we can expect. I mean, we already know After a Few, which has been such a huge hit for you, and I'm so happy to see that it's moving up the charts. So what else is going to be on there, man?
Really, I mean, I think this is the best kind of first, like, kind of look into, like, the story I want to tell, which is, you know, the people I come from, the place I come from. And I think half of this EP is going to kind of hit people in a way where it's like, that's exactly what I expect from Travis, you know, high energy, like some party songs, some drinking anthems, you know, some heartbreak songs. But I think that there's another half of this record that'll really kind of surprise people and kind of give them a new look of some music to expect that they haven't heard before. You know, like the song Sitting by Fire, I think is going to kind of hit people a little left field, which is exactly how I want to always kind of do it, you know.
Love this. Okay, so we've known each other for a while. I met you. You were a songwriter and you were pitching songs. And now we are hearing one of those songs. When I was just listening to Michael Ray was just doing something and he was playing Her World or Mine, which that you had a hand in. So what's that like to simultaneously have your stuff taking off and then songs that you've had a hand in also find success?
It's crazy, you know. In my whole plan, you know, when I was 15 years old, my plan to stardom, I kind of wanted I wanted success as a songwriter first, and I was lucky to have that. But this whole thing of like having my song, like After a Few, be top 10, and then a song I co-wrote be my first kind of songwriting top 30 and song to really climb the charts, all happening at the same time, is a it's wild. It's really crazy. I mean, I kind of always thought you'd have one or the other at different times. And the fact that they're kind of both happening at the same time is nuts. It's a blessing. It's something I never expected to happen. So I'm fired up. Michael just absolutely killed that song. He sounds so good on it. And I'm happy it's working not only for, you know, me and my co-writers, but I'm pumped it's working for him because I love Michael. He's a great friend. I think he's a great artist.
Does it give you pause now, Travis, that all this is starting to take off? Do you ever look back and think about some other songs that other artists have either on their albums or they're got them on hold or whatever that you're like, oh, I wish I would have held on to that one for myself?
Nah, I'm pretty pumped with how everything's turned out. And I'm excited, you know, because you know what? Like, if those songs had not been cut, they wouldn't have been a part of my story. They wouldn't have been a part of what's gotten me here. And, so, yeah. Now, that being said, I mean, I kind of would cut Pickup Lines again since Justin Moore didn't put it on the radio. So I might have to maybe one day cut that song again.
You know, that's always down the road. I love hearing that. Hey, I do have to ask you, I saw this and it hit close to me because I love, love, love Charles Kelly's solo album. That to me is one that I've got like on a playlist. I listen to it front to back, like all in order. And I was really surprised when you said that that was part of your influence for After a Few.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that song, when I hear that song, I just see a picture. Like I see this like, you know, this couple in a low lit bar in a corner booth that probably shouldn't be hanging out together, but they are. And I just, I wanted to kind of take that picture and do it my way. And it's funny because when that interview came out with that, a lot of people were like, dude, I never saw that. But a lot of people say exactly what you said. They were like, that is literally one of my favorite records, one of my favorite albums. And it was cool. Charles tweeted me back and was like, dude, that's awesome to hear and love your song and all that. So that record is just awesome. It's just too bad he can't sing, you know. I mean, I think if he could really learn how to sing, then maybe his career would really take off, you know.
We'll keep our fingers crossed for him. Bless his heart. He's working so hard at it.
Yeah, for sure.
So tell me more about how this whole landscape looks now. Because, all right, now so we're releasing the debut. Obviously, you had touring plans. You had all this other stuff that was planned. Everything is on hold. So what is it going to look like for you? I know you just did Hoda and Jenna, right?
Yeah, that was kind of right before everything shut down. And man, that was wild. I mean, first off, that was amazing. It was pretty early morning. I wouldn't recommend doing it every day, but, man, it was a blast. I gotta say, like, everything about it was so professional and awesome. They made us feel good. And, I played that show. All hell broke loose pretty much is what happened to me. it hit the fan shortly after. So, but for that to be one of the last things that we've done, obviously I know we're going to get back on the road. Things are going to go back to normal at some point. But that's not a horrible high note to at least before break, you know, to have.
Absolutely. What's it like in quarantine for you? I know you're very type A and go all the time. So are you trying to do co-writes? Are you writing a lot? Are you just trying to relax and, you know, take it in while you can before it gets busy again?
It's a little bit of all of that. I have been writing a lot, which has been great. I mean, I don't want to really turn off the creativity ever. Like, I constantly want to keep that wheel going and those legs moving. But, you know, usually cracking a beer by 3:30, maybe 4 o'clock if I've had a really busy day. And, it's both for sure. Like, I'm still trying to have some sense of normalcy, but I also understand that, you know, for better or for worse, this is an opportunity that's been given to kind of sit down and reflect and enjoy some time off. So I'm going to try and do a little bit of both.
All right. Who's on your quarantine playlist right now? Who are you digging and listening to?
Well, truthfully, I've been loving the new Dua Lipa record. I don't know if you've listened to Dua Lipa, but I mean, she's awesome. So Dua Lipa, let's see, who else have I been listening to? Let's just go to the old Spotify. Why don't we here? Let's check my recent search.
I think you really should. I want to hear. This is the kind of stuff people want to know.
So I've been burning up some Chris Knight. Ain't nothing new from Chris Knight. He's just an amazing songwriter. I listened to Ronnie Dunn's solo record for the 367th time, probably. And, here's one. DMX and Mystical. Kicking it back to the old rap days there.
Well, hey, you know what? Here's the thing. Diplo's putting out an album now, and he's got Cam. I mean, like, I feel like all of the lines have been blurred anyway. And people are now just starting to discover how cool country really is. So if you were going to do like a mashup with somebody, put it out in the universe. Who do you want to like collaborate with that's completely outside of the genre?
Oh, it would probably have to be Halsey. I mean, she's one of my favorites. One of my favorite artists. I think she is she's awesome. I mean, for lack of a better word, she's a badass. I mean, she really is. She's a great artist. I love her songs, I love her music, and so I would love to do a duet with Halsey, so that'd be cool.
So you were gonna go out on the road, you were with Sam, right? Sam and Kip?
Yep.
What was that like in your head when that all came together? That had to be a moment that you're thinking, okay, this is gonna be a whole lot of fun, and I'm probably gonna pick up some fun little pointers along the way somewhere.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, honestly, like, it is a dream tour. Hey, we're still going to do it. Just got pushed a little back. But for me, like, man, I've known Kip for a good little while. He's a great dude. we love to, like, he loves Bruce Springsteen, all these things that we've talked about. And I just know that we were going to have some great moments, and we're going to. I've been a Sam Hunt fan since he came out. I think he is amazing. I think he is truly what the word artist means. And, man, you know, I was kind of hoping to, like, put a little muscle on, too, around those guys, maybe, like, lift some weights and stuff and get my shoulders a little broader. I've been calling it the 2.5 men tour, you know, because you got old scrawny me opening up the show. But I think it's going to be awesome. I think it's going to be so cool. And, hey, 3 Georgia boys, man. I mean, it's you can't ask for anything better.
Oh, my goodness. It is going to be a good time. I can't wait till we get to see all of that live and be in the middle of all of it, hug everybody again. I mean, here's a question. What's the first place that you want to go eat when this is done and they're like, we're good, there's a vaccine, go out, do whatever you want? Where's the first place you're hitting up?
I'm going to Cinco de Mayo restaurant, and I'm getting 4 margaritas and every bag of chips they got.
Just going to say, you know, they finally passed it in Tennessee. You can do curbside margaritas now.
Yeah, I have done that law. I've lived out that law once or twice. Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
Best thing that we've done in quite a long time. Man, I'm so happy for you. I'm excited for the success. Good things are coming. I mean, just happening all of it and wrapping it up with a nice, neat bow. It's going to be a good year, I think, once we get past all this.
Hey, I appreciate it, and I totally agree. I think it's awesome. Always a pleasure to talk to you, and I'm glad you're staying safe and washing your hands. I mean, I'm washing my hands.
Wash your hands, and then go get yourself a beer.